Who you want? Who you like? Baby, tell me who you loving. Last time I checked, it was me, but you bugging. What's going on, Bella Gang? It's your girl, Lover Natural, back at it again with a brand new Juicy Girl Talk. Bella Gang, best friends, in this Juicy Girl Talk video, I'm going to be telling you how to get over your ex, how to stop missing him, craving him, and all of that. And I'm telling you, after you watch this video, you're going to be completely over his ass, okay? But before we get into the Juicy Girl Talk, let's get into this pink bob. I'm so in love and so proud of myself because I colored this hair myself. I cut this into a beautiful bob. This hair is from Miss Coco Hair. This is my first time working with Miss Coco Hair. And let me tell you something, Miss Coco, I love this hair. No, but seriously, this hair came in a 613 blonde 12 inch wig unit. It looked like this when I first received it in a cute box. And you know, your typical packaging, well, not typical packaging, it's a cute box, I like the box, but it came in your wig box. It came with a cute handheld mirror, which I thought was really unique and cute. And this was, like I said, it was 12 inches, but I wanted to go for a shorter look, so I cut this bob, and I didn't even cut it even, honey, but I just wanted to go for like a short, like a blown out Dominican blowout type of look, and I got this. And comment below if you guys like this bob. I cut it myself. If you want to achieve the exact same color, I use Adore rinse in cotton candy and the Kiss rinse in rose gold. I poured in the whole bottle of each, stirred it. I did the watercolor method. I drenched the whole wig in the conditioner, VO5 conditioner from Dollar Tree, and then I took a big plastic bin and filled it up with hot boiling water, put like a good half a cup of conditioner. Yes, for those of you who do not know, if you want the color to pop, conditioner is the secret. I put conditioner and then I stirred in the conditioner, then I can't talk today? Like, I don't understand. I put the conditioner and then I poured in the rinse colors and then I put the wig in it and I let it stay for like a good 20 minutes to get out, let it dry overnight. It looked like this. Then I began to style it. I always lay my wigs down with Got to Be Gel. And yeah, I really love this hair. It's, first of all, when I wash this hair, no tangling, no shedding. The only time it shed is when I was plucking you know, the units make it look natural, but of course that's gonna happen because I'm plucking the hairline, right? So yeah, I have no complaints about this hair, guys. If you guys want your information about this hair, it will be linked in the description box below. Without further ado, let's get right into this video. How to get over your ex. Don't forget to like, comment, thumbs up this video, and definitely subscribe to my channel. If you're new to my channel, hey, welcome to the Bella Gang. Love you guys. Okay, sis, so if you really wanna get over your ex, first, you have to think to yourself, do I really want to get over him? Because sometimes we feel like we want to get over our ex because, hello, like it did us dirty, we have to move on. But that's not necessarily true. Before you successfully completely get over missing your ex and, you know, getting over him, you have to mourn the relationship. It's okay to spend a month, 2 months even, I don't care if it's 3 months, to really cry, really mourn. For me, I find that I get over my ex when I read, for some reason, don't judge me, but I like to read our messages over and over. And then I also like to replay in my head what he did to me to make us like break up, especially if he cheated. If he cheated, that should give you the ammo to be like, oh no, I deserve better. But it's easier said than done. I know, sis, it's easier said than done. I personally can't stand, you know, if my friend be like, all right, girl, it's been like 2 months, get over him. No, because let's say you guys been together for like 3-4 years. It takes time. It takes time to really get over someone. You know why? Because you gotta get out of the routine of being with them every day. You went from being with this person every day to not seeing them at all, to loving them, to now you guys are goddamn near enemies. You know, his ass almost got you on the first 48, you know what I'm saying, because of what the hell he did. So that's a lot of trauma. And the thing about this generation, or people in general, people expect you to get over trauma so quickly. And you cannot get over things that affect you in a negative way. Because when you don't know how to deal with trauma, guess what? It grows into, now you have different type of mental disorders, you know, chronic disorders. I suffer from chronic anxiety based on life activities and traumas. So if you want to have a healthy, just keep yourself like level-minded and healthy and have a peace of mind, you know what I'm saying? having a peace of mind, you can't just say, oh, I'm going to get over my ex like that. You first have to mourn the relationship so that you can feel better. You can feel better about yourself when you get over him. You cannot get over someone if you didn't get over the hurt and the pain. You have to heal from the inside. So F what you heard. Don't listen to your friends telling you, listen, stop talking about him. That's how you're going to get over him. No. Matter of fact, don't tell people about, you know, your ex. And don't tell people that you're going through it, because they're not going to feel sorry for you. They might feel sorry for you the first week, maybe the second week. But after that, they're like, all right, like, how much time you going to talk about Aaron? Like, Aaron played you. Like, get over it. He's with somebody else. No. Me, personally, I always pray to God, like, before I start my healing process and mourn, I pray to God, like, God, this is what happened to me. I can't believe this happened to me. Just give me the strength to move on from this, because I can't do it alone. Because in all reality, you cannot do it alone. You cannot get over somebody by yourself. I needed the strength of God to let me get over certain people. And it's crazy, because there's a lot of guys, you know, I used to date and I used to be so in love with it. And to this day, I have no reaction. Like, I feel like I could literally sleep with them and feel like nothing. I could kiss them and feel like my grandmother kissed me on the cheek. Like, it's so weird. And I'm happy, because it's like, wow, at one point in time, I couldn't get off his page. I was stalking his ass. And now he's stalking me, honey. He is stalking me, and I want no parts. I don't want no parts of you. Okay, baby boy. Like, be small boys. Like, I don't even want you no more. And I want you guys to get to that space in your life. You know, especially if it was a toxic relationship, let me just say congratulations, because if to get out of a toxic relationship is extremely hard. So if you guys really broken up for real, and you're trying to get over him, let me just say, I know it was probably very difficult for you to even break up with this guy. So congratulations to you guys for that. Now, moving on, like I said, the first step is healing. So I go to God for healing. So once I pray, then it's like, okay, now I prayed about it. What's the next step? The next step is I cry my eyes out. I know, guys, this advice is probably like, what? I gotta be honest with you, because this is what helped me. I cry my eyes out. I reflect on the relationship. Like I said, I go through text messages and I read everything. And then I think about what he did to me. And then I cry. And honestly, crying was meant for people to feel better. I don't know about you, but every time I cry, I feel better. Let's say I'm going through a lot in my life and I cry and I pray and I cry. You know, I'm talking about not just any cry. When you cry, I like that. I like crying, that type of crying session where you cry so much and then you go to sleep right after and you wake up and your eyes is puffy cry. I know you're probably like, what? Like, why would I want to cry that much? Because it's a release. Because you cannot have all of that pain that you're going through and keep it bottled inside. You know, stress can kill you, right? That's why some people, they die from a broken heart, from someone that passed away. So you got to release that some way, somehow. So crying is a great natural way to cry. I mean, it's a great natural way to release. Because if you don't release what you're feeling, you might do self-harm to yourself. That's why some people cannot really process the hurt and the pain they're going through, because nobody really is there for them. They feel like they have nowhere to turn. So they start cutting themselves, unfortunately. Before you get to that point, because a breakup can turn you suicidal, a breakup can cause you to self-harm. Before you can get into all of that, I want you to save yourself by doing it the natural, safe way. Cry it out. You know, cry it out. I like to cry, listen to therapeutic R&B music. I like to have my favorite snacks, like ice cream. Ice cream definitely helps you with healing. I don't know what it is about Häagen-Dazs, but I love Häagen-Dazs coffee ice cream. I just, you know, I watch my favorite TV shows. You know what I'm saying? I try to self-medicate with peace. You gotta be as calm as possible and be at a peaceful mental state as possible. Because the more peace you have, then the more you can like calm down, because going through a breakup can cause you to think irrational thoughts, to probably think, like I said, suicidal thoughts. So you have to calm yourself down or you're going to be an emotional wreck. So that's what I don't want you to be. I don't want you to be an emotional wreck. So for you to prevent yourself from going over the edge, you got to pray. You got to do things that's going to make you feel better. Crying made me feel better. Eating my favorite ice cream made me feel better, you know. And also, another way if you want to get over your ex is I said this in my other video. If you're going through something, guys, I strongly advise that you get up out the house. I don't care, even if you don't have friends, get up out the house, take yourself out to a date. Go on a date, take yourself out to eat, get your nails and your feet done. You wanna start feeling pretty again. Cause I don't know about you, when I'm going through something and I miss my ex and, you know what I'm saying? First of all, a breakup can make you feel insecure, less than. I'm not pretty enough, I'm not attractive enough. And you know what? I've been in relationship with guys that made me feel like that. Like I wasn't good enough, like I wasn't pretty enough, like I ain't slay enough. Because is that why you left? Like what is the problem? So, and that can be very dangerous to your self-esteem. So you wanna rebuild yourself. I say, like I said, get your nails done, get your feet done, put on some makeup, even if you're not going nowhere, just to feel better about yourself. Because when I'm going through something, I feel like I feel ugly inside and I just look ugly on the outside. I don't want to do my hair. I don't even wear a wig. My Meek Mill braids be like 2-3 months old and I just have no makeup on, look crazy as hell. And when you look crazy as hell, you feel crazy as hell, okay? You don't want to look like what you've been through ever. You don't want to look like you're going through a breakup. When somebody see you, it's like, damn, you can tell she's going through something. No, never look like you're going through something. Even me, I've been through so much shit, guys. But I come on my YouTube channel like, what's going on, what's going on, Bella Gang? It's your girl, Loving Natural. Like, it's nothing, because I have to do this to make myself feel right. Because if I don't, who's gonna do it for you? God only helps those who help themselves. So yes, we can run to God, but He wants you to rebuild yourself as well, and then He'll do the rest of the work. So after you successfully, you know, mourn your relationship, and now you're getting back into the groove of looking better. Now that you're looking better, you're feeling better. Another way to stop missing him completely is, stop thinking about him completely is, oh yeah, I also forgot to say, while you're mourning the relationship, I think lurking on your boyfriend's page is actually a healing process. Because for me, it's so weird. I will lurk on his page, lurk, right? Until I see him post another girl. It's like I wanted something else to hurt me so that I can really say, okay, that's enough. Like my last situation, and when I seen, like, you know, I used to go on his page, I'm like, okay, typical stuff, he's with his friends. But when I see that he posted someone else with like a heart emoji, honey, I was just like, you found love. You found love. Wow, I'm hurt. But you know what? Now it's like, Now you can think to yourself like, wow, he definitely moved on. He's definitely not thinking about him, about me. So why am I thinking about this man? Who clearly doesn't give two shits about me. Why do I care about this person? Think about it. Why am I putting myself through months of maybe he'll come back? When you go and lurk on your man's page and you see he's with someone else, sis, I hate to break it to you, but he ain't coming back. He might come back and try to mess with you while he has his girlfriend. Because 9 times out of 10, if he broke up with you off another girl, then he's probably going to try to do this. He's probably going to try to cheat on his new girl with his ex, which is you. That's what guys do. But you don't want to fall for that. Because you know what? Guess what's going to be created out of that? A situationship. Now, a love triangle. Do you want to be in a love triangle? I don't know about you. I don't like sharing my man. Do you like sharing your man? I don't. Next, you know what? You having a fist fight with this girl. All because of what? Because love allowed you to, you know, love is blind. Love can make you have irrational thoughts and feelings. Like on Love and Hip Hop, when Peter, the season with Peter, Amina, and Tara, Amina was telling Tara, listen, this is my man, this is my husband, this is what I'm sleeping with. And then Tara, and she's a strong-minded, independent woman. You could tell that, you know, she doesn't suffer from low self-esteem or nothing, but love can make you do irrational things, because love has to make her do irrational thinking, because she turned around and said, well, I sit on it any chance I get. Y'all remember that scene? She's like, well, I still sit on it. And it's like, she know that Peter is now married to his side chick, but she still was sleeping with him. But you can't blame her. And I can't call her a dumbass. Because we all been there where we know we have no business being back with an ex. We know he's talking to somebody else. But then we find ourselves, like, still picking up his phone calls and still, like, you know, still believing that he still care and love us. Like, I don't know about you, but the guy I'm talking about, he has a whole girlfriend, but will call my phone, blow up my phone, like, oh, like, wow, you really forgot about me. You don't miss me. You don't care about me. But hello, your ass is in a relationship. But they, Guys will make you go crazy. I swear, like, you're in a relationship, but then you're saying you miss me. You don't miss me enough because you didn't try to salvage our relationship. So you don't miss me. You just miss me giving your ass attention. Not on my watch. Okay? Like Ayana say, not on my watch. Don't allow a guy to mess with your brain and make you feel like, you know, you guys are getting back together, because you're not. Especially if he has a girlfriend now, he doesn't want to get back together. What he probably want to get back to is the sex. He probably want, you know, every now and then to be, you know, having sex with you and engaging, you know, intimately with you. But that's about it. Like, exes who come back to you usually come back for either they want attention from you, or they hate that you moved on, so they still want to have like a leash or a type of control on you, so they make you think like they miss you. But no, it's a control thing, because if they miss you that much, they will be back with you. Always put that in the back of your head. If a guy wants you in his life so much, okay, you're gonna get back in his life. Also, always remember, no guy likes you that much if you're still single. And no man loves you so much that you don't have a ring on your finger. So let's say if you've been in a relationship with somebody for years, and you always talk about marriage, and he never, you know, he always try to, you know, deflect from answering that question. You have to give yourself a time limit to where you get a ring too, because 9 times out of 10 guys like that, and you guys break up after 10 years, 6 months later, they engage to somebody else. That's the harsh reality when you hold down a no good ass guy. Stop holding down these F boys, okay? Start holding down kings. And you know when you have a king, you just feel it. But a lot of times, we know we were F boys, and we know we could be with somebody who treat us better. But for some reason, it's always the guys that treat us like gold that we don't want. It's always the guys that have the mommy issues and all of that have the best D, but they drive your ass crazy. I don't know. It's like, I don't know what it is about women. Like, why do we attract the bad guys? Why do we allow the bad guys to rip our heart to shreds? But it stops in this video, honey. It stops now, because you deserve more than that. Your big sis is telling you, you deserve more than that, period. And that's something that I had to deal with. I had to, you know, start over with loving myself. Clearly, I didn't love myself, because I would know somebody's an F-boy, you know, I do everything I'm telling you guys about, but then the minute he called me, I'm back. He back in my bed. Like, what? Like, what the hell's wrong with me? But then I thought to myself, when you're in love, you do irrational things. That's why when you go through a breakup, I strongly recommend that you become celibate, because sometimes sex can allow you to allow your man back in your bed. Like I said, like, you know what I'm saying? You know, you be feeling like, damn, it's been a minute. You don't want your body count to be high. So he's calling you. So it's like, all right, come over. No, you're going to regret that shit. I'm telling you, every time I allow my ex back in my life or allow myself to sleep with their ass again, I regret it, okay? It's not like they're going to leave their girlfriend for you. That's another thing. If you were the ex that has a new girlfriend, and you can tell when a man truly, like, loves somebody else. So don't ever think to your head, like, well, he said he don't really love her like that, da da da. What do you mean? He's in a relationship. If he didn't love her like that, he would not be well. He would be with you. Remember that. And that's pretty much all I have to say about, you know, how to get over missing your ex. Also, the final thing, like I said, I do recommend lurking on his page until you find him posting another girl, because that should give you the ammunition to say, all right, F this and block him. When I truly was hurt, when I seen that, I block him. Block his number, block him on Facebook, block on Instagram, block, block, block. Block, 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 okay? Blocking spree. When you truly block someone, because when you block someone, you have to physically go and unblock them. So if you find yourself going to unblock them, always think to yourself, wait, my big sis said, when you unblock somebody, now it's like you erasing everything that you did. Like, you know, you're erasing the whole healing process. When you unblock somebody, guess what? The old feelings is gonna come back. The anger is gonna come back. When you see stuff on this page that's gonna hurt you again, because I promise you, you're gonna find somebody. I promise you, you're gonna find something on this page that's gonna hurt you. And then you're like, damn, my sis told me this. I'm telling you guys this for your own good, because I'm your big sister. Come on, I've been there, done that. Why would I want you guys to go through what I went through, you know? Block him completely, keep yourself busy, and there's no man and no dick in the world that will make you never get over somebody. I promise you. Give yourself a year. Because it does take a full year to completely get over somebody. And you're going to be like, damn, my sister's right because I can't even stand him. Ew, I dated him. You're going to throw up a little bit in your throat because you're going to be like, ew, I dated him. What? He's not even my type anymore. That's the mood that you got to have, sis. Period. So if you guys like this girl talk, definitely give it a thumbs up, comment, subscribe. Press your notification bell right next to subscribe. Press the subscribe button and the click the bell so that you get notified every time I upload. I love you guys so much. Like I said, this hair information will be linked in the description box below. Love you. Until next time.